Hey guys, welcome back to another Hardcore Ironman Progress video. Gonna pick up straight where we left off in the last video and go ahead and do lots more quests. And that's 50 fire making. I believe that's the highest level I need for the quests that I want to do at the moment. I can now use Winter Tod, I believe, which is pretty nice. And of course need 50 fire making for Desert Treasure. So good to get that one out of the way. So I am hoping to finish up the rest of the skill requirements for Recipe for Disaster and the requisite quests. So at the moment I am training my mining. I need to get 50. After that I also need to train some thieving. I'll probably get up to 53, I think that's the level I need. And of course some cooking. I also need to get some magic logs for Desert Treasure. And at the moment I'm a bit unsure what I'm going to be doing. Probably Winter Tod, to be honest, but if it's going to be too slow, I might train my hunter up to 58 for nature implings and do it like that. Of course, that'll take a fair while to get, but we'll see. Winter Tod is good for resources anyway, so I think that is what I will end up doing. There we go, that is 50 mining. So now I think I'm going to move on to thieving, get that up to 53. After that, it might be smithing. I haven't decided if I'm going to do in between a rock, which does require 50, I believe. I might have enough ores in the bank. But other than that, it's just the magic logs left for Desert Treasure. I'll probably do a bunch of quests before that and leave the magic logs as the last thing to do, because I still haven't decided how I'm going to get those. But yeah, I feel like I'm getting there. And that is the Tears of Guthix quest done. Incredibly easy, took about 2 minutes. I'm really looking forward to having this minigame unlocked. Hopefully will be a nice way to get some easy construction and hunter levels. Once a week, of course. 76 tiers, not too bad for my first time considering I don't have that many quest points. Let's see how much XP I get. Oh nice, all the way up to 12 construction from 7. So for the Temple of Ikov quest, I need a U shortbow, and an easy way to get it is to kill an angry barbarian spirit. So I've come to the ancient cavern. Fingers crossed I'm not going to get smacked and killed by a brutal green dragon, but yeah, let's see. So I've been killing these for a fair while now. I've nearly used 2,000 fire strikes. I really don't want to be using prayer potions, so what I've been doing is literally just killing one and then teleporting to the monastery, teleporting back to the outpost, and then coming back. It's incredibly slow. I didn't think it would take this long to get a used shortbow. Honestly, it's probably better to get a few hunter levels and hunt young implings, unless you've got like good combat stats and you can kill these quicker. As you can see, it's very slow for me. Fingers crossed, I get it soon. So I've decided to give up on getting the longbow from the barbarian spirits. It's just taking far too long, and I can get it from trapping young implings. I believe it is a rare drop from them, but I can obviously catch young implings at a much faster rate than I can kill the barbarians. So as much as I dislike Hunter, as much as these early Hunter levels are really annoying to train, yeah, I think it's for the best. There we go, that is 33 Hunter. So I can actually catch the young implings barehanded, which is what I got up to 32. And I figured while I was here, I'd just get the extra level, because when I come back to train Hunter, I can go ahead and do Kebits for a little bit. I probably will come back and do Hunter at some point, because I think doing nature implings for magic logs is probably my best bet for Desert Treasure. So a bit more training for that, and gonna go ahead and hopefully get that U-bow now. It is a very rare drop on the young impling drop table, but should be able to find plenty of them in Puro Puro. Didn't think it would take me this long, but finally got the U-longbow. Actually got a fair few hunter levels solely from catching the young implings and opening the jars as well. Pretty ridiculous how long it took me in the end. Yeah, about 300 odd young implings, so I pretty much spent the whole day just trying to get this damn bow for the quest, but finally got it so I can crack on with the quest and move on now. And that is the Temple of Ikov quest done. A very short quest considering the amount of time it took me to get that Yulong bow. Quite a decent amount of XP, a few range levels and a few fletching levels as well. Just hit 60 magic. I'm currently in the middle of doing Hero's Quest and I need to pick up a dragon bone for Watchtower, which is what I'm going to be doing after this. So yeah, just a random level killing a blue dragon. Of course, I forgot to flameproof my fishing rod, so I've got to do that long run through the maze again. So I'm just about to finish the Hero's Quest. I'm curious to see how many levels I get from this because it does give you a lot of XP across a whole bunch of skills. So 979 skill total at the moment. Only the four levels, but plenty of XP. So that is always welcome. And another quest done, Watchtower. Four quest points, which is really nice, and can use the teleport spell as well. So that's pretty decent. Also 5k coins, which is literally increased my cash stack by 50%. I really need to make some more money. And Hasil Cult is done. Burning through these quests right now. And that is the Tower of Life quest done. Just burning through a couple of quick ones for the quest points. Should be a few construction levels as well. Very nice, 15. And that's Eagle's Peak done. I think that's just the one hunter level as well. Just finished Zoga Flesh Eaters, so a little bit of Herblore XP, ranged XP, and Fletching XP. But to be honest, the main reason I did this was for the Super Restores. I kind of wish I'd been a bit more frugal with them during the quest. I only have three doses left, but should be quite useful for Desert Treasure when defeating Camel, because obviously that area drains your stats, so yeah, that should come in handy. Making prayer potions, which can only mean one thing, it's time to actually do some difficult quests. First one is Monkey Madness. Don't know if that would be classed as a difficult one, but I haven't done it in such a long time that I have to admit I am a little bit nervous, so fingers crossed it doesn't take too long. And yeah, above all else, fingers crossed I don't die. Alright, so it's time for the final boss fight. I've literally got the shittest gear going. Gonna kill it with range because it's got a pretty high magic defense. This is what I'm running with. Should probably get some arrows, that would be a good start. Jesus Christ. I don't think I'll have too much trouble with this. It might take a while to kill because of my level, but I've got prayer potions and protect from magic, so it won't be able to do any damage to me, hopefully. Let's see how this goes. And there we go. He's dead. That took about 5 minutes. Used just over one prayer potion, so that's not too bad. That wasn't too bad. And there we go. That is Monkey Madness done. It wasn't too bad in the end, to be honest. It's not that difficult if you're well prepared, and I have overhead, so yeah, not too bad. I'm now only 10 quest points and 4 quests away from being able to get those Barrow's Gloves, so I need to do Underground Pass, Regicide, Roving Elves, and Desert Treasure. Just going to pick up this diamond before it disappears. So in terms of training, I need to get 53 Thieving and the Hunter level to be able to catch Nature Implings, which is what I'm going to do for Magic Logs, as I've said before. Let's go and pick up the XP from Darrow and see how many levels I get. So because I need to get 60 attack for Dragon Weaponry, and that's something that I want to get as soon as possible, I'm going to focus on improving my attack and defense It's not too much of a difference between the two, to be honest, but let's see where we get up to with that. Very nice indeed. 13 levels that got me in total. And I've just breached the 1,000 total level mark as well. That's really, really decent. I'm very pleased with that. 61 combat as well. And there we have it. That is 53 thieving, of course, the level that you need for desert treasure. The only other skill that I need to train now is hunter, I believe, for the magic logs from nature implings. I'm going to go ahead and do underground pass. Might wrap up the episode before doing desert treasure because it's getting a little bit long, but yeah, this wasn't too painful at all, actually. And that is underground pass done. I honestly don't know why people complain about this quest. Maybe I've just been lucky when I've done it and had a fairly high agility level, but yeah, it does take a while, but it's not particularly tricky. So now need to train my hunter and collect those magic logs. I think I'll probably need to do one more quest after desert treasure just for a couple of quest points, because I can't really be bothered to do regicide at the moment because it's quite long. I'd rather pick something slightly shorter. But there we go. Very, very close to starting to get those Barrow's Gloves now. So I'm going to end the episode there, guys. It's getting a little bit long, and I do want to upload because I haven't gotten a progress video out in a week. So I hope you've enjoyed watching the video today. I feel like there's been a fair amount of progress. Going to pick up exactly where we left off next time. I'm determined to get this hunter done, get desert treasure done, get the cooking requirement done for recipe for disaster, and get those Barrow's Gloves unlocked. I'm really going to push and try and get that done this week. But until next time, thank you very much for watching, and take care, guys.